Hi everyone, my name is Sedat. I would like to welcome you to our webinar. Today I will introduce cashflow forecasting that allows to forecast future bank balances based on provisional future transactions. It allows to generate provisional transactions based on SYSTRONICS 300 transactional data. The module is integrated with SYSTRONICS 300 for SYSTRONICS cashflow. It allows to print cashflow forecasting report and a graph. As a rule, when you need to make a forecast to your cashflow, you do it using an Excel. The benefit of using SYSTRONICS cashflow forecasting is that it reads the data already available in SYSTRONICS 300. The application uses data from AR, AP, as well as OE and PO models. Now let me open SYSTRONICS 300 and show how the application works. Let's assume that we are currently in the beginning of June 2020, and we would like to make a forecast for the bank, here bank, for July 31st, 2020, using cashflow forecasting. The central point for the cashflow forecasting module is the management consultant screen. Let me open that screen. As a beginning, we need to select the bank. I select the bank here, bank, and then we need to specify the dates. The form date is the current date. We assume that we are in the beginning of June. So the June beginning is selected here, and I want to forecast at the end of the July. So the July date is also specified here. And now I need to click the Go button. When I click the Go button, the current balance of that selected bank is filled on this field. This is the actual bank balance as of June beginning. But in this moment, I don't have any forecast information on my screen. As I told you already, we need to use the SYSTRONICS 300 data in order to make the forecast. For which data we can have a forecast, how much cash inflow and outflow we will have during this specified period. For example, these are the invoices entered in AR and AP modules. If I have an invoice entered in AR, for example, it has a due date, and I can forecast that during this due date, I will have a receipt against that invoice. So this information can be used. How it will be done in this using this module? There is a special screen for that named as auto-generate provisional transactions. So I will click that screen, the button and screen will be open. Select the AR invoice option. The date during which I assume that I will get the payment against the invoice is the invoice due date. It is possible to specify also some additional days and the date range. So from the document date option, I will select the beginning of June. And up to end of July. When I click button, go button, the list of open invoices is populated here with the current balances of these invoices. So here I have a generate button. This generate button will generate the special transactions named as provisional transactions, which are the transactions only for the forecasting purposes. So I will click this button. And 17 transactions for 17 invoices, the provisional transactions are created. I will close this screen and my management console screen. On my management console screen, I will have this 17 provisional transactions. Why it is named as provisional? Because they are not real. They didn't happen yet. I expect that I will get this receipt amounts against each invoices. So here we see the date, we see the customer from whom I will get the money and the amounts. And because of this specified of our forecasting amount, the balance of my bank will be changed. If it was from the beginning 30,000, after each receipt, the running balance of my bank will be changed, and at the end of the period, I will have a closing balance, which is more than my beginning balance, about $12,000. So, what else I can do? What other type of transactions can generate a forecasting amount? When we speak, when we are talking about the inflow, these are the order entries, open order entries, against which we expect that the invoices will be created and the invoices will be paid. So again, I will use the same screen, allowing to generate provisional transactions. Select the order entry. And now, from the drop-down list, I can change it, the transaction date as expected should be. And again, from the selection, I will select the same date range, June and July. Click Go button. But I have one such invoice, such order. So I will generate a provisional transaction from that order. The corresponding provisional transaction is added in the list. In addition to receipts, of course, I will have a payment. So my balance will be reduced because of that payment. I have to pay against the AP invoices. So on the generate provisional transaction screen, I will specify the AP invoice option, select the date range, and similarly. I will populate my screen with payments against these AP invoices. So I will click generate. And quite big list of payments are generated. But as you can see, the amounts for the payments are shown in the red color in order to differentiate the receipts and payments. And my running balance now will go down. And from the current balance of 30,000, now it becomes 4,000. And let's add the payments against PO orders. From here, I will select the arrival date and the same range. Click generate. As you can see now, my bank balance becomes negative. Of course, this forecasting helps me to avoid having a negative balance, to understand what should be done in my business, what transactions else should be generated in order to remain in a positive range. So, in addition to existing transactions which are entered already in SYSTRONICS, it is possible that you have an information about receipts and payments which are not documented yet, which are not entered as transactions in AR models. If you have some this type of information, the corresponding provision transaction can be entered manually without using any existing transaction. To do that, there is a special screen, create provision transaction. And from that screen, I can enter the transaction menu. So if it is a receipt, I will use the customer receipt option. Let's say that expect from 1,200 customer, 10,000. Edit. And corresponding closure transactions, transaction is added here. It is possible to generate closure transaction from account budgets. If you know that your certain account budget is so much and you expect that this budget will be implemented during this period, you can use that information and against that budget, corresponding closure transaction will be generated again. Another possibility is that we will know that there is some new deal, some new business that will generate cash for us. Let's say that we know that from our sales team that we will have $10,000 doing a certain new job, new business, and for that, to get that profit, we need to spend a certain amount, let's say $6,000. So I will enter that. There is a special screen for that. Create new business. The screen is open. And from this same screen, I can enter the both inflow and outflow information. I just need to specify, let's say, for inflow the customer. And for the outflow, I will specify the vendor. Not enough. I will save it. I will click generate provision transactions button. And when I will generate, two transactions will be generated. One is inflow and another one is outflow. So these two provision transactions are added here. And the balance will be increased based on this information. What else? It is possible that you will analyze the existing list of your transactions and will find out that some transactions are not will not happen now. They will happen later, let's say. The date is not correct for some transaction. So I expect to pay for this payment, for example, not during the June, but not during the August. So I will change the date. Also, it is possible that the amount of some transactions we need to change. In that case, the amount can be edited from here as well. So I will edit it as required. And it is possible also that some transactions will not happen at all. So I don't need them. So if it is just one version transaction, you can use this option to delete only one by one version transaction. So I will click delete. And if there is a need to delete a range of transactions, then there is a special screen for deleting a range of version transactions. I will just select the transaction that I need to delete, and after selecting, click the delete button, and this transaction will be deleted. In addition to this way of creating closure transactions, there is another way using the recurring transactions. What are the recurring transactions? It is possible that you are paying certain amount for, let's say, leasing, for renting, for subscribing some services. And in order to do that, we can use this special screen for entering those recurring transactions. If you need to do that, first you need to specify the schedule, whether this recurring happens monthly basis, weekly basis, or somehow different. And then enter the amount of this recurring transaction. And after that, you will click the create closure transactions, and a list of recurring transactions will be generated automatically. I will open once more my management console screen and populate already entered information. If I'm interested to print a report, there is a special cash flow forecasting report which can be printed immediately from this screen. So if I will click print, the report can be printed in a summary or detailed type. If I will select the summary option and print it, it will print the main information on the beginning balance, inflow and outflow information, and ending balance. So these four amounts will be shown here for each period. If I will print the detailed form, in that case, each transaction will be printed in the report itself. But also, it is possible to include graph. We will select the weekly option for the graph, and we will see how nice it will be shown at the end of the report. for those total transactions that are due during this calendar, which is the beginning of July. So this transaction should be treated somehow. Either they should be deleted or an actual transaction should be. I will open from here my management consult screen. And on management consult screen, I should have something to get that. I should delete it by clicking the delete button or create the actual transaction. The actual transaction, how to create the actual transaction? There are two options. One option is to delete here and go to the corresponding AR or AP module and from there to create the actual receipt or payment. Or it can be created, the actual one, immediately from this. It is very good option to do the job quicker and easy. So let's say the first one is a receipt transaction and I want to create the actual customer receipt. To do that, there is a special button here, generate actual transaction. I will click on it and select the generate actual receipt. I will click the new button, new batch will be generated. And click generate button. And the screen will be open for me. It looks like the actual AR receipt and fiscal. It is the same screen actually, but it is open from the client module. And it is a customized AR receipt and fiscal. And from here, as we can see, the amount of the provision transaction is already filled here for the same customer. And if the transaction has an information about the allocation, then the allocation will be done as well from here. Let me go back and select another transaction. Let's say this one. This one also doesn't have allocation information. However, but if the provision transaction has that information, then automatically the allocation also will be specified here. And we just need to save the receipt and post. Actually, this was all that I planned to show you today. Thank you.